All right, gang, so here's the deal. This video is going to be in two parts. The first part, we are going to be going over some of the bugs that I have found and fixed. And in the second part, I'm going to be giving some channel updates. If you're only interested in the channel updates, I'm leaving a chapter link down in the description and as a pinned comment so you can skip right to it. It's fine, I don't mind. With that out of the way, first things first. One of the mistakes I made while working on the user's update function was that if you go ahead and click edit, and let's say we try to edit the first one, and let's say we put in a bunch of stuff and press edit, everything looks like it goes through as expected. User has been updated, but if you take a look, the user has not actually been updated. Even if we refresh, the user is not updated. What that means is, if we head over to the code and we go to the user controller, if we head over to the update function, you can see here that we are looking for if the request roles is null, and then we're looking for if the ID does not equal 5, but we have not looked at any other cases other than that. These are the only two that it's actually looking for. So what we need to do here now is put else, open up some curly brackets, and then here we can say user update. And then all we need is the name and the email. That should be good. Let's go ahead and give it a try. Back to the browser, refresh, and now let's go ahead and try to edit the user. And we're going to add some text, edit. User has been updated, and our user has actually been updated. The other thing I want to do is display the user with capital letters for their name. Let's head back to the text editor, and now we'll go to the user index. If we just do a quick search for name, that's the header, and in here we can put class equals text capitalize. Let's head back to the browser, refresh. Now our names are capitalized. Fantastic. So the other thing I wanted to do is, we had an issue where when you click create and you create a new user, we're using the same form for our edit button. What we wanted to do was make it dynamic, and my mistake, I entered it incorrectly. So we are going to go back and make that work. When we were trying it before, I think it's roles index that actually had the computed property that worked. This didn't actually work, because when I was testing it, it was throwing up errors again. So I'm going to copy this. I am going to head back to the users. We'll start there first. Here's our form. So I'm just going to comment that line out, and I'm going to put form, and then we'll add the same information. So at submit prevent equals check mode. So now let's head down to the data properties. So this check mode, we need to make a computed property now. Down to the data section, right under computed properties, we're going to put check mode. We're just going to say return this edit mode equals false. So if this edit mode equals false, then the method that we want to run is this create user. If it's not, it'll be this edit user. If you take a look at the roles, the way I had set it up was using the parentheses to try to call the methods. But what was happening was every time the page loaded up, it would run these functions. And these functions, these methods, were throwing up errors every time. That's why it wasn't consistent, because I was calling it like this instead of how I'm doing it here. Mystery solved. Now, before we go ahead and check it, let's go ahead and clean up the rest of these methods with the other things that I found. Okay, so edit modal is fine. Open modal. We only need these two. Close modal. We can keep. Create user. We can get rid of the form reset. Edit user. We can also get rid of the form reset. Now, the reason I'm getting rid of it is because we have now just solely left it to the close modal. So every single time the close modal will run, it'll run not only this form clear errors, it will also run this form reset. So we will not need to have it down here. Let's go ahead and try this and see if it works now without error. Go back, refresh, and also let me open up the inspection tools. And we are going to open up the view dev tools so that we can see them in our computed properties. We can see them change. Let's go ahead and open up our index, and we'll drop this, head straight down to the computed properties. As you can see, the button text with the create for the text, which is correct, but that'll be on the inside. The method that it's bound to now, the check mode, is create user, and the form title is create new user. If we open up create, our button is create, our title is create, and now let's check the method. So new user, new at test.com, create. New user was created, and let's make sure that our form had been reset. Fantastic. Now let's go ahead and click the edit button. We have edit current user. Our button says edit, and we have our user in here. And also, if we refresh the dev tools, you see that now the button text is updated, the method is updated, and the form title is updated. And that's exactly what we were trying to achieve before. Now we can say updated, edit. You see, we have had no errors. We can refresh. We're fine. Everything is all good. So now we need to go and add that to the other index pages. So let me scroll up because I want to get rid of that form line that we have. Now we can remove this confidently. We can close this one. We can close the controller as well. Let's go ahead and handle the same thing in our roles index. So we'll get rid of the parentheses. And then we'll scroll down. Edit modal is fine. Open modal, we can go ahead and get rid of this. Close modal is fine. And then on create, we can get rid of this form reset. On edit, we can get rid of this form reset. And delete should be fine. Let's give this a spin. Let's head over to the roles table. And let's go ahead and do the same thing. Open this up a little bit. Index down to our computer properties. We have create new role, create new role. Let's go ahead and create a new role. Add some permissions on it. We'll just say delete user, new test, create. New role created. Let's go down to it. Let's open up our index again. We have our new role right here. And then our computer property, create new role. Now let's click it, edit. Let's refresh, button text is edit. Our method is edit, and our form title is edit current role. So now let's try to update, and then we'll even add a new permission to it as well. Edit. Fantastic, role has been updated, new test update, still no errors, we're doing very well. So now let's go ahead and do the next one, which is permissions. And I'm going to go ahead and just do this really quick. See that? Super fast. Head back to the browser, open up our permissions table. We'll also refresh that. Open up our create, and let's open up our index so that we can see our computed properties are fine. Create, it's bound to the create permission title. Let's create a new permission. New permission description. Then we'll click create. Of course, it's too long, so we'll take off a few letters. Try it again. Create. We have new permission, and this is our new permission right here. Let's go ahead and click edit. So now let's go ahead and refresh the components. Button text is edit. Check mode, edit permission, edit current permission. New perm updated. Click edit. Permission has been updated. No errors. Fantastic. So the last one I want to work on is the admin. We'll open up index. And we don't have the need for a computed property in this one, but we do need to change up some of the functions. Open modal, this one, we don't actually, what we do, yeah, that's right. We're not using this edit mode, so we can get rid of that. And we only need these two. That can stay, that can go. Let's make sure that this one now works. Go back to the browser. We'll go ahead to our admins. Let's try developer, edit. Developer's fine, still can't click. We'll change developer to new test update. Update. Admin has been updated, and you can see the role is now new test update, which is also a admin role. Fantastic. We have now completed this. I am sorry for all of the errors. I do try to make sure that everything is clean and that everything works as it's supposed to. And if it's not, then I will let you know in advance that it doesn't really quite work the way I want. So I do try to make sure that if I'm going to show you something, I'll add that caveat if I need to. But I had no idea. So this is me fixing it so that you guys have working functions, because I know that that computed property was annoying. It was a really great feature and I couldn't get it working. But through hard work and perseverance, I went back and I figured it out. So now we are getting so close to 1,000 subscribers, and I want to thank you all for helping out with that and for coming on board and trusting me to teach you the things that I know. I wanted to do the 500 milestone, but apparently within a day or two of me hitting 500, my channel was attacked with a spam bot attack. And what that means is someone decided to pay a company money to send me a ridiculous amount of subscribers with a ridiculous amount of views and likes or whatever. Now, I don't want to accuse anyone of anything. I'm hoping that they were trying to help me instead of trying to hurt me. Essentially, whatever it was they were trying to do, they went and spent money and did it. So I wasn't quite sure of how many subscribers I'd had at the time because of that attack. So I didn't do 500 because I didn't want to, you know, jump ahead of anything. I just want to say that I do not support that. I do not think that's a good idea. I don't think that if you were trying to help me, the best thing that you could do for me is to watch my videos, comment and like or dislike if you dislike or whatever it is, engage with the channel. But if you're trying to help me, that's not going to help me. That's just fake numbers. Those are, you know, and the numbers don't really mean as much as they do versus when you guys tell me that I was able to help you with something or something that I did helped you get through a project or maybe even got you a job or whatever, just something as positive as possible. Trying to help me by giving me a huge amount of fake subscribers does not help me. At the end of the day, it was a massive waste of money because what YouTube does is it scans through all of the channels on its platform and removes those sketchy accounts with the sketchy views. So those subscribers were taken away anyway. It's not worth it. Trust me, it is not worth it. Because at the end of the day, if I get one subscriber, I get one subscriber. But if people are watching my videos, then that is what helps me. That pushes the algorithm to push my videos out to more people. And the more people that we do get involved in watching are the more people that will have the skills that they need to go forward and pursue the things that they want to do. When you do something like a spam bot attack on a channel, you're suppressing that. And that to me is not right. So like I said, I do not support that. And I really wish that whoever it was would never ever do it again. And that's all that I'll say on that. When we actually hit 1,000 subscribers, what I'm going to do to celebrate you guys is I'm going to respond to some Q&A, some questions and answers. I'll be giving the answers. What I want you to do is at the bottom of this video in the comments section, if you have any questions for me, you know, any kind of a thing that's not too personal or whatever, then I'll go ahead and feature those in its own 1,000 subscriber episode. That's how we'll do it from there. I think that'll be kind of fun. As long as the questions aren't too personal, I will probably answer all of them, if not most of them, but I will try to keep the video, you know, within reasonable limits. One of the cool things about reaching 1,000 subscribers has been that YouTube will basically open up some more resources to content creators to make the creation and the viewing experience for users to be more enjoyable and more community oriented. And so once you reach 1,000, one of these tabs will open up into a community post. Now, recently they've reported that in October, I believe it has to be this month because mine is gone. There used to be a discussion tab down here, and it's not. So I guess I'll be getting the community tab soon, hopefully. Okay, but basically the reason I bring that up is because with that community tab, I can add polls and I can do different things with it. I'm not even sure, but we'll find out and explore it as we go along, which is fine. So I had finally used my discussion tab, and I see now that it's gone, so you guys probably did not even get to see what I put. What I wanted to do was, I thought it would be something fun for us to engage in. So I am currently working on a very big project, and I am hoping to have it done a week after this video is published so that we can get to work on it and you guys are enjoying it. But what I did was, in the discussion tab, I had posted a comment where I asked the question of, if you guys can guess what the next project is, the first person that's right in the next project that I'm doing, I will feature that post on the preview episode of that series that will be coming up. Now, the other part about it is that if you guess it right and guess the stack that I will be using, then you will be able to choose the colors for what it is I'm doing for the project that I'm working on. So it'll be maybe 3, maybe 4 colors for the theme for the project. You'll be able to pick those colors for me. Now, again, as I said, I put it in the discussion tab, it's gone, but I've also posted it in Twitter. And as you can see, or I said I didn't disappear, I'm working on it. So either way, what I would like you guys to do is, if you guys are able to guess it and guess it correctly, put your guesses down in the comments down below of this video, and then any video obviously in the future. But if you post what you think that the project is going to be, then I will let you know once the preview episode starts to be released. And then if you also guess the stack, then I will also change up the colors to include the colors that you decide for the project. Okay, I think that would be really fun. So you can either comment on this video here, or you can send me a tweet on Twitter. I'm not a Twitter person, but I'm trying my best. I don't do social networks, but just comment on this tweet right here. And if you're correct, then I will choose you. Now, another thing that I wanted to add as far as something that I'm doing with the channel is that the videos that I'm going to be putting out, I am going to try my best to be more proactive about adding chapters so that the videos themselves are broken up in a way that you can navigate to different parts. Like this video specifically, I'll use it as an example where I'm having a chapter go from what we were doing with the coding to what we're doing with channel updates. And this way you guys will not have to sit and listen to me drone on for 30 minutes or whatever it is, and you can just get exactly what it is you came here for. I'm gonna leave it there for now. I'm gonna make sure that I push up the code that we did do today up to GitHub. I will leave the link for that down in the description. I will also have, as I said, the chapter links, and I will also leave the link to my Twitter so that you guys can reach me on there. You feel free to follow me, that's fine. Thanks for watching, thanks for the support, and I will see you guys next time.